Hello and welcome you all. Today we will solve this 44 number problem asked in CSIRnet June 2019. This is a problem of heat equation. To solve this problem, you need some basic concept of homogeneous heat equation, and after that you need to find the expression for UXT and then analyze the options, and the correct option will be in front of you. So it can take little time. But regarding the GATE exam, this type of questions are very important compared to the NET exam. So let's try to solve this question. This is the given homogeneous heat equation along with these conditions. Okay. To solve this kind of problem, you should know what is the general solution of a homogeneous heat equation. For that purpose, simply del u del t is equal to k del 2 u del x 2. This along with u x 0, some function is given to you as f x, and u at this is equal to 0. This is the boundary condition and this is the initial condition. Okay, so this is a standard homogeneous heat equation and its solution is UXT. This solution you have to remember, because in the exam hall it is impossible to find the solution of heat equation. It will take too much time actually. So for that purpose you need to remember n pi l square to t, n varies from 1 to infinity. Okay, clear? So this thing you need to know. Now from the given equation it is clearly visible that k is equal to 1 and our capital L is also 1. Okay, simply put in this formula and you will get a n sine n pi x into e to the power minus n square pi square t, n runs from 1 to infinity. Okay, so this part we have used because from here, from this boundary condition, actually we are getting the value of u of L. Okay, and we have used the value of L here as well as the value of k. Now we are going to use this condition. That means we need to put t is equal to 0 in the solution and we will get ux 0 is equal to summation a n sine n pi x n 1 to infinity, and this is given sine pi x. Clear? Now if you try to expand this one, you will have plus a 2 sine 2 pi x plus a 3 sine 3 pi x and so on. Clearly it is visible from this expression that a 1 is equal to 1 and rest of the constants, that means a 2, a 3, a 4, all are equal with 0. Clear? That means you are getting a 1 is equal to 1. So finally your UXT turns out to be UXT is equal to only a 1 will be there and rest of the terms will be 0. So finally what you are getting from this expression is sine pi x into e to the power minus pi square into t. So this is your final solution of the given heat equation. Clear? You can easily verify that it is satisfying all the given boundary and initial condition. Now come to the options one by one. First option says that there exist ordered pair xt in 01 cross 0 infinity such that uxt will be equal to 0. Is it possible? That means in x belongs to 01, there should be some x for which sin pi x is equal to 0. Obviously, it will never hold in that interval. Okay. Obviously, it will be equal to 0 in the limiting case, but they have given as t belongs to in this interval 0 infinity, not the limiting case they are considering. That's why your first option is false. That means there will be no such ordered pair xt so that uxt is equal with 0. Correct? Similar logic we can apply for the second option. Second option says that the same thing they have given, that there exists xt such that del u del t is equal to 0. That means for that purpose you just differentiate this one and you will have something like that, y square t, and by the same logic you will say that there will be no such ordered pair for which del u del t is equal to 0. Thus second option is also false. Actually it is the same logic as we have applied for the first option. Now come to the fourth option. Fourth option says that there exist the ordered pair xt in the same region such that uxt greater than 1. But look at your uxt, it is actually sin pi x and e to the power pi square t. That means it is actually like this way, it is e to the power minus pi square t. So it is this. If you take the mod both side and immediately you will get e to the power pi square t. Obviously it is less than this kind of quantity. Clear? In fact this one is obviously less than 1. Clear? For any value of t you will get that relation. Clear? Thus your fourth option is also a false one. Clear? So the only correct option is option 3. Okay.